Liz's view of her role was explained in a Guardian interview. My job is to look strategically at the five networks. I think of them as a map of Britain and the way they all fit together. There's a gap in the middle between Radio 1 and Radio 2, and different views on how it should be filled. We could make Radio 1 older, or Radio 2 younger. My emerging view is that the BBC cannot do everything. This was an interesting new viewpoint, and she seemed to be endorsing the musical gap that was opening between Radio 1 and Radio 2. The BBC had such a tight monopoly of national airwaves with Radios 1 and 2 that I suspect John Burt and Liz Forgan saw this as a potential political problem. Their response to calls for privatisation was to allow a gap in which the new national commercial station could compete hard. The overall BBC plan seemed to be deliberately make Radio 1 younger and Radio 2 older in order to open up a gap for Virgin Radio. Liz Forgan was even quoted as saying that Virgin Radio shouldn't be strangled at birth. She said, "There's a natural audience for Radio 1 that stops at age 25, and one for Radio 2 that comes down to 45 or 50. When I read that quote, I suppose I should have seen the writing on the wall for myself and the network as it then was. I wasn't as complacent as I appeared in respect of Radio 1's positioning. I'd been with it since it started, and I could see the audience profile was getting older along with the station. While it attracted big audiences, Radio 1 wasn't doing enough to bring in new, younger listeners to the BBC family of radio stations.